So when it's challenging, there are a lot of people in the school who know how to use that technology and would probably be willing to help you learn it if you just ask. And my advice would be to admit when you don't know something and to search out somebody willing to help you, because that's what teachers and schools are all about.
When things aren't going well with technology in the classroom, you have to make a judgment in the moment of whether or not you should persist in trying to troubleshoot or whether you should just decide you need to take a different tack. And I think the fundamental thing that should come first and foremost is the students. If you are trying to do something where you are using a smart board, let's say, and the smart board isn't loading, there's some software update going on, it's just not working, can you have the students read a page in the book that you're going to talk to while you're trying to troubleshoot? Like, can you give the students something of value while you're doing that so that there's still learning going on and you don't lose control of the class?
Technology is something that changes on a daily basis. It's hard to keep up, but if you take it as an opportunity to learn something new and challenge yourself, that's also a great model for students.